there's a line drawn in the sand between physical and digital in this household. Enough said.
Get away from me. Get off my lawn.
You get the same money, all right? You're spending the same. They're just getting more.
Why are you spending more for less?
I'm not spending
more. Yes, you are.
I'm spending the same amount for the same damn thing.
I've been seeing this topic circulate everywhere on YouTube. It seems to be the in thing right now. More than anything, this is a video response to Gaming Off the Grid. We reached out to them. They noticed in their area that physical media is dying.
Disappearing.
It's just
off the
gone.
They showed a lot of video that we went into two different stores. One, I think, was a Best Buy. The other one was
Target. Yeah.
And their shelves were practically empty. While I'm watching this video, I'm getting mad and scared at the same time. And I said, we went out that evening in our area. We checked Walmart and Best Buy.
Yes.
So we had to compare to see. And now there can be a difference between where they're living and we live.
Yeah.
Because there is a difference when it comes to thrift stores.
Oh, yes. Definitely. So on the day we went out to check out everything, we had been noticing, possibly before Christmas, a little bit of a decline. I think there was a time we went out, so we were like, well, let's go check it now. So we went to Walmart, we went to Best Buy, we want to check the stores, and we were pleasantly surprised that it had a lot of stock. That being said,
they are condensing the space or the footprint on the floor of their games.
Yeah, so is it just looking like there's more?
Because no, we definitely had more on the shelves. But
no, I'm saying, is it looking like it's more than it's ever been because it's in a smaller footprint?
No,
you know what I mean?
There's definitely less than there ever. It's just not as bad as what they're seeing yet.
Yes.
I just don't know if we caught up.
Well, we're in East Coast Canada, so we seem to live like a couple years behind the times of what generally goes on everywhere else. We didn't go to GameStop that day because GameStop is a gaming store, so it's hard to be subjective about that.
I have noticed one thing with GameStop now.
Yes.
When it comes to pre-orders, they will only order the amount of games that are actually pre-ordered, and usually they don't buy anything over that.
And our GameStop closes ridiculously early
now. Oh, their hours have been cut back.
Clearly, there's a decline in physical.
Yep.
I think it's so slight or so well managed by condensing that shelf space that not everybody's seeing it all at once. And we're gonna talk with Alex a little bit later and we're gonna get into digital versus physical, but I'm also noticing that, you know, we went into Best Buy, you have your shelf of like little cards you can pick up to go buy your digital game.
That's the digital game, so.
Stores are supporting it whether they want to or not. They have to, and we never seen digital consoles before, and we do now. So they're making steps. Whether you see it with the naked eye or realize it's happening, the steps are being made.
I think in the next 5 years, when we look back from now till then, I think we're gonna be absolutely shocked at where it's gone.
Well, brick and mortar's going away. Why would Best Buy and Walmart have a ton of games on their shelf when you can go get them on Amazon? Why would the gaming market pay for physical space on a shelf when they can put their inventory, their physical inventory, in Amazon or their digital inventory? You can get digital games on Amazon too.
Yes, you can.
This is where we're going.
I don't like it.
No.
I hate it.
When digital games come out that aren't going to be physical, or they say they're not going to be physical, that is like a trial run to see if the consumer likes the game. And you're made aware that this is digital only. So you buy it. And then they see, oh, people liked this. Let's put out a physical copy, because there's kind of a safety net there with putting that digital out first and then going, let's put a physical out now. We know people will buy it.
But we are shooting ourselves.
We are.
Especially the double dippers. And don't say you don't double dip, because I watch YouTube and it's just a hell of a lot of you guys that you can't wait. I have to play this game day one. But then you also want to have it physically.
We do it.
So what you're doing.
We do it when we don't know.
I've done it a couple of times and I really hold off now. I wait. I wait. And the reason why I wait is because if I don't have to play it today, that digital game is there. It's going to be there for a while. I've got a year. I've got, I don't know how long.
Yeah.
I'll walk.
You've got time.
I'm waiting to see if I can get a physical. Now, if everybody jumps on board and buys the digital game, then what they see is the amount of their digital sales are way higher than their physical sales, because maybe there's 3 months in the difference between the two different sales. If people would wait and say, I don't want that digital game, sell me a physical copy and wait for that, That would change things real fast, because that's what people and these big corporations sitting behind a desk, the only thing they know is when they look at a spreadsheet and see numbers. This is on us. If we want physical media, stop buying digital first.
Yeah.
Buy physical first. And then if you want a digital copy and not open that, do that second. At least that's a small step. It might help. I don't know.
The only caveat to, I will say, it pro digital is that I do understand, to be an indie developer, it is damn hard to get your game seen on a physical market and to get that physical space if it's not a AAA title.
Yep.
So if you can bring it out digital first and then see if there is interest, and I understand that.
I think that we have to support the indie games more. But if, say, a big title comes out, like a God of War or something, a big game is coming out and they push that digital copy there and you're like, no, you guys got way too much money invested into this. We want to start seeing physical. At least give us both options on day one. Most games are, but some games aren't. Yeah. There are some games right now, some RPGs that came out that are digital first that I cannot get a physical copy for months.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I don't understand, but yeah. I mean, maybe that's, like you said, we're old and get off our lawn, people.
Holding out. I'm like, get off my lawn until you get something physical.
Yeah. Well, you know what? We're going to get Alex in here. We're going to see his take. I see this getting heated because I see them sometimes talk about digital versus physical. He does not respect his physical games, not as much as we do, because how many times have you gone up there and seen a disc outside the case sitting? That's what I'm saying. He is definitely a digital collector, so we're going to have his little digital butt in here, have his take on it. I'll move to the side, and I'll try to mediate as best I can, so we'll see how that goes. Well, we have Scott on one side, a self-confessed console gamer. And we have Alex on the other side, a 30-year gap, a self-confessed PC gamer. Now, can you tell me, in your opinion, what's the benefit of the physical game?
I don't know if there's more of a benefit when it comes to digital or physical. I know for myself, when I buy something, I'd like to physically have it. I know that I own this, and it's not something digital, and like, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And like I feel like I purchased something and I own it.
It's the
digital, I don't feel like I own it. I don't see it unless I turn the console on and start looking through the library. With my physical games all in the room, I can take a look around and see what, you know, tickles my fancy. What am I going to play next? What console do I want to do? You know? And that's something that if I want, I can sell it. I can trade it or lend it to a friend.
You can do all of that digitally.
Okay, well then, But tell me then, I guess, what's the benefit to digital?
I mean, I think the obvious thing is convenience and profit. It's infinitely more profitable for developers.
But that's not you. You're not profiting.
I'm saying why they're doing it.
Oh, I know why they're doing it. It's for money.
Yeah.
But, I mean, for you.
What's
why,
the physical benefit?
We don't care
what's
about
the,
them. Why
the
do you prefer?
The benefit for the digital. Yeah.
It's convenient. You get it there that second you buy it.
Mm-hmm.
And while I know for some platforms, they can just take it from you, from your library, and then maybe if you have to sell it, you can't get it back.
They blacklist it. Yeah. You lose it.
The worst that ever happens on Steam, which is basically a monopoly on PC gaming, it's all digital, all that there, is that they will take it off the store. They very, very rarely, and it's only when it's basically a legal thing or a TOS violation in terms of service, that they ever take it off of your library. And obviously, you still have the executable file. They don't have control of your PC, so they can't really just take it from you.
You're obviously very pro-digital. You're very pro-physical.
Yeah.
At some point, we will die.
Yeah.
Okay. What is your thoughts then on getting this collection?
Keeping
the entire
games,
library,
yes.
Plus
30 consoles,
yes.
Are you gonna play them? Are they gonna be a shelf piece? Are they gonna be in storage?
It'll be a mix of. I'll play some of them that I want to play. Not everything.
See, at that point, there myself, like I'm gonna be dead. I would much rather pare it down to things I know that you're gonna enjoy, possibly play with my grandkids, you know, maybe even your grandkids, possibly.
Your wife.
I won't sell the single solitary piece of any of this, no matter what.
Really? So you wouldn't want us to pare it down then either?
I don't know what that means.
Pare it down, meaning that
shrink the collection.
We would shrink the collection to stuff that would be considered fodder. That would just be filler
I would
stuff.
Be fine with that, but I wouldn't personally do it.
No?
After it's been passed down to me, no.
So you would just basically be keeping it for sentimental reasons?
About 70% sentimental, 30%. I do want these things.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, that's... I mean, obviously then you're not so far... pro-digital.
I'm pro-digital.
But not so much so that you
I'm not
can't
trying to
appreciate
destroy
the physical
random
media.
Stuff. You don't I don't think anyone is.
I kind of wonder, and I would like to add this in here, what have been the statistics maybe 10 years back, moving forward to now? Because we didn't have digital-only consoles 10 years ago. When did Steam come on the market? How long has Steam been around?
I think that it was around the time the 360, early those eras, I think, around then.
Okay.
Because Steam was originally made by Valve so they didn't have to deal with publishers because they owned Steam.
Okay.
And then it turned into just a huge store market because they had all the stuff to deal with.
So yeah.
They did extra money. That's where most of Valve's profits come from now, Steam.
Things are getting more expensive. Are we moving digital a little bit too for space?
I don't think so.
No? Do you don't think it's a space issue?
Not
you
even
don't,
kind of.
No?
I mean, it also takes up space on your hard drive and all that.
I know, but it doesn't take up this sort of space.
It takes up much less space, obviously. But putting this much on hard drives, you'd have to have several hard drives or one absurdly expensive hard drive.
Okay, so you're not really saving a whole lot of money going digital?
Depends.
Because if you have to have a really good computer.
To run the most modern games, yeah, you have to have a really good computer. But to be fair, the hardest to run games on PlayStation 5 versus a good PC, it's going to run infinitely better on the good PC.
Well, I have a question. I know you love your Pokemon.
Yep.
You're never probably going to ever get rid of your Pokemon collection.
Not in a million years.
Would you prefer to play it on the original hardware, or would you emulate it on your PC?
Depends how good the emulation is. Emulation is not nearly as good as the original thing right now, so I'd obviously just do that.
So a new Pokemon game coming out, where you have no nostalgia for it, but I'm just playing devil's advocate and say it does. Would it matter if it's
digital or not? No.
No, it wouldn't matter. I think the only reason the ones that you have matter to you is because it's nostalgia. It's nostalgia for you because you picked it up, you played it on the console
that's
first.
True.
Like yeah.
Did I get your first Pokemon game?
Yeah, Silver.
Or Christmas, yeah, sure. Silver.
Yeah.
I own one of every generation.
Yeah.
Up until the newest one, because that one sucked from everything I heard.
I think where we stand right now, I still want physical. I think it's just a generation thing.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't care, and you are just want
here's
digital.
Here's where I look at it. Digital will cost me the same, maybe a little less.
See, that's what drives me crazy. Why am I paying the same for digital when the physical copy, there's actual stuff there? There should be that cost cut in your digital copy, and that pisses me
off
more than anything.
Does that make you frustrated?
Doesn't bother me.
Do you not agree
with
me?
I'm not buying it for the case, I'm buying it for the game.
But it should be cheaper. You're saying that it's more profitable for that company.
Fine. That's fair for them to get more profit.
Generation drive me nuts.
Why would they hand us the profit? That's just bad business.
Why would you pay the same for less?
Not less to me.
It's less!
It's more to me, because I don't have to go to a store and spend gas, so it's cheaper.
There's a sucker born every day. This one was born 15 years
that's
ago.
That's making it, why?
Why would you say, okay, there's a physical game right in front of you, or this game right here, and it is, let's just say $100. Say it's $100. And then there's a digital game that I can buy.
A picture of it?
There's a picture on a screen that I can buy for $100.
Here's the thing, is it right there? If you can summon
I can! It's called Amazon!
It takes time!
This game and it'll
it
be
takes
here tomorrow.
Time! Yeah, tomorrow! It's here right now in an instant!
I can pre-order it at GameStop!
So you have to go there? It takes effort? You have to go there?
Oh my god!
Princess!
It's the freaking street, Princess!
It's convenience and you get nothing out of going there! I am not buying a game to look at the game on my shelf. I'm buying it to play it.
If the digital copy was the difference between what you actually got physically, mm-hmm. I don't care if it's $5. It should at least be the difference. It blows my mind that you are fine with paying the same amount for less. It drives me absolutely crazy.
You would be the worst owner of a business ever.
How are you supposed to barter and get deals in life? You're just like, how much do you want? Okay, can I give you more?
He's so right, Alex.
No, he's not.
It's I cry for the generation
you
coming
in there. You are expecting this company to just take this profit it has no reason to not just take and give it to you. Are you a fool?
There's a fool sitting at this table right now.
If you think whining about it's gonna... Yeah, I wish they did. Tough luck.
But it should be.
Sure. What does that change? They're not gonna.
Oh, you're charging me more for nothing because of convenience? Oh, I understand. Here you go.
Charging you more for... It's the same thing. And also, listen to me. Listen to me. You're not charging me anymore. You're charging me the same amount. You're just getting to keep more.
Anyway, there's a line drawn in the sand between physical and digital in this household. Enough said. All right, that's cool. All right, we're done. Awesome.
I didn't know you guys were buying the game so that you could look on at it on a shelf.
It makes sense.
What? You what?
Yeah, I have an.
You didn't know? All right, we're trying to make fix that game and then. All right.
If it was digital, we wouldn't have this problem.
Get off my lawn. Well, that just happened. So, am I crazy? Am I crazy? Tell me. Am I one of these get off my lawn guys? Am I just too old to get it? Like, tell me. Am I crazy?
No!
Well, you're old like me, so, but, like, am I crazy? Please, tell me. Be honest in the comments there. Like, I
Why
don't get...
Why is this generation willing to pay more?
Yeah.
I know it's not more, but when we're talking value-wise, he's getting something digital. When we're talking what we're getting the game. Yes, it's a digital download, essentially, but we're getting the case. We're getting to see the product. We can resell it more easily than what he's saying he can resell.
I think it drives me crazy that, to call them the big three, record profits every year.
Mm-hmm.
And he is willing to just increase those profits and doesn't care.
Why is digital not like even like, $10 less?
It should. They lose money if it's in the store because I assume the store takes a cut.
I'm sure
they have
pay
to rent
space
in the store.
Yes.
They have to produce the discs and print the labels and buy the cases. Like, there's all that's money. I'm sure
and
there's got to be a few bucks.
Then
on
you're
each
possibly
game.
Sitting on overstock.
Inventory, yes.
Yeah, you're sitting on that. So,
The big three should do the right thing. If they want to go this way, instead of hoarding all their profits, throw a bone to the consumers that are all struggling these days because the economy has gone right to hell.
Tits up.
Yeah. Like, we are taxed to death here in Canada. And his generation just is fine. I don't care. Here you go.
My
keep
mommy
taking
will
money.
Give me the
keep
money.
Giving, here's
mommy
your money. There you go. Take all my money.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm too old.
Maybe. Alright guys, until next time, drink! Because, game on.